Turn your dreams into reality. Toyota, let's go places.
Hello, and thank you for stopping by the Toyota Dream Project virtual booth. My name is Tanisha Jackson Warner, and I'm the founder of the Dream Project. I am also a proud HBCU alumni graduating from Alabama A&M University. On behalf of Toyota and the Dream Project, we're thrilled to be here today as sponsors of Harlem's Fashion Row HBCU Fashion Virtual Summit. But most importantly, we are thrilled to be here to support you in driving your dreams forward. For over 5 years, Toyota and the Dream Project has traveled the nation, empowering thousands of dreamers, just like yourself. So it is only fitting that we partner with Harlem's Fashion Row to fuel the future of fashion. And you heard that right. You are indeed the future of fashion. I am so excited about this edition of our Fueling Fashion Fireside Chat because today we are talking with a phenomenal dreamer who has carved out a niche for herself in this hyper-competitive world of fashion as well as beauty publishing. She started her career as an intern at InStyle magazine and rose through the ranks at the magazine to several key positions, including beauty director. Now she is a leading fashion and beauty expert, inspiring a new generation of women to embrace beauty from within. Plus, she is a proud HBCU graduate as well, graduating from Howard University. Please join me in welcoming Kahlana Barfield Brown. Hello, Kahlana.
Hello. Thank you so much for having me. There is absolutely nothing that I'm more passionate about than HBCU students. So I am so happy to be here and honored to be here.
Well, we are so excited to have you. So I could not do your bio and background justice. I wanted to make sure to give you an opportunity to do that. So Kahlana, let's start by you sharing with viewers a bit about yourself and your career journey within the fashion industry.
Well, I think you did a great job, but I guess I would just add, you know, I'm born and raised in Seattle, Washington, and I left Seattle to go to Howard. And I spent my 4 years at Howard HU. And the day after, I majored in journalism and I minored in fashion merchandising. And the day after I graduated from Howard, I moved to New York and started interning in fashion magazine. And I always think that that's such a critical part to leave in the story, because a lot of times, you know, when you're in college, you graduate with a degree, you think you're about to walk into a job that's paid with your degree. And I did not. I walked into an internship that paid me $6 an hour. And that's all part of the journey. So I moved to New York. I started as an intern and really just worked my way up. I started as an intern in the beauty department at InStyle. I did that, and then I was eventually hired, and then I just moved through the ranks. I was promoted to assistant beauty editor, then beauty editor, then senior beauty editor, beauty director, and that was where I gained all my experience. And I think it's been 2 years since now I've been working for myself and doing a multiple of things, consulting, working with brands, and, you know, working on some really, really exciting projects that are coming up. But yes, yeah, so I spent majority of my career in fashion magazine, and I started as an intern.
I love it. And I'm learning as I'm listening. I'm so glad you called out the importance of being willing to even start as an intern after graduation. I do know a lot of graduates, you're ready to hit the ground with that job. So if you're listening, there's power in keeping sort of that serving mindset and being willing to give. I have this thing, Kahlana, that I say, sometimes you have to be willing to give to get.
And absolutely, it's
like you were able to do that.
Yeah. And I think too, just making sure that, you know, you are ready to do the work. You know, I think that that was the thing with me. It was like, I knew what I wanted for myself and I was willing to do whatever it took to get there. I wasn't above anything. There was never a time where when I started a magazine, it was like, oh, I'm not getting someone's lunch. It was like, if that's what I have to do, that's what I have to do. And I'm going to do it with a smile and I'm going to do it and I'm going to be happy to do it. And I think that that is the mindset when you really, really want to pursue your passion and pursue your dreams and you're willing to do whatever it takes to get there. You kind of have to have that attitude where you're just willing to do the work and you're not afraid to get your hands dirty or to get your feet dirty. And I think that that will set you apart.
Willing to do the work. Okay, for all of the dreamers that are watching, I hope you got your pens and your notebooks out because Kahlana is dropping the wisdom.
Yeah.
Okay, so we just went over a lot within your career track, doing everything from the beauty director at InStyle to now your collaboration with so many brands that you've worked with in the past, from Nike to Lancome to Estee Lauder, as well as so many more. So inside of this very impressive career, I want to know, what would you say, like, what impact did your HBCU experience at Howard University have on your career path?
Ooh, everything. You know, I think this goes across the board with HBCUs, but definitely because I went to Howard and I rep Howard so hard, I can speak about Howard University. But Howard has such a long history of people who have graduated from Howard and have been the biggest in whatever they do. You know, Felicia Rashad, Chadwick, Diddy. And that was, I was walking on the shoulders of them, you know? So for me going to Howard, they showed me, I always say, if you can see it, you can be it. So it, a lot of times it, I like to think, it wasn't until I got to Howard where I really saw someone who looked like me. I'm from Seattle. So, you know, the Black community in Seattle is very small. It's a tight-knit Black community, but it was a very small Black community. So when I got to Howard, I was like, yes, I'm home. These are my people. These are my, I see people that look like me, that talk like me. It's where I even feel like I was able to, I saw people that dress like me. And, you know, so it just was everything for me. But when I saw, oh, this person can do that, and she looks like me, that gave me all the inspiration that I needed. But I think one thing that I learned about Howard is that if you're going to do something, do it to the best of your ability and aim to be the biggest. So for me, it wasn't like when I knew I wanted to work in fashion or beauty, I never thought, okay, I'm going to move back to Seattle and try to do this from Seattle. It was like, okay, go where you can be the biggest. So I'm moving to New York. There's no other option for me. This is where I need to be to get the experience I need to get, to make the contacts that I need to make. This is where I have to go. So I think that that was something that I learned at Howard, where it was just about like, go after whatever you want and you can do it, because we can show you everyone who's done it and you're walking on the same campus that they walked on. So you can do it too. So I think that just that inspiration and seeing people who look like me live out their dreams is what gave me that extra push. But I think across the board, that's what I love about HBCUs, is that we're around people that look like us, that are doing the best and doing the biggest that they could do, you know, out here. I mean, I'm you know, lived in New York for the most of my adult life, and I recently moved to LA, but there's not a day that I don't meet somebody that went to Howard and it's like, oh, Howard, you know, and they're the top person at Netflix. And so that is, you know, that is the motivation that you have and your colleagues, and you're, you know, you're around that all day. So I think that that's what just keeps you driven.
Well, when you were talking, I just got chills. And one of the reasons why is you said when you were at Howard, it seems that you are seeing all of these examples that it's possible.
Yeah.
And even now in this moment, Kahlana, there are over 15,000 viewers that's watching this content that will now know because of you, it's possible.
Yeah.
So, you know, I just got chills because, you seeing someone and knowing it's possible made you go for it. And now you're doing the same for so many others. Another point for all of the dreamers that's watching, that's a universal truth in a dreamer's journey, especially as you drive your dream forward. You know, you heard Kahlana say she didn't go back to Seattle after she graduated, which would have been her comfort zone. It's what she knew. She was willing to expand and go outside of that comfort zone. Yes. And Kahlana, that's something that as we talk to other dreamers, I hear it over and over, this notion of being willing to stretch and expand toward your dream.
It is so easy to go back to your comfort zone. And I think for me, I come from the mindset, well, my grandmother, you know, she was the biggest HBCU advocate. She was the one who encouraged me and my siblings to go to HBCU when she went to Southern University. And she always said to me, you can always come home. If nothing else fails, like try, get comfortable being uncomfortable. You know, my friend always says that, get comfortable being uncomfortable, put yourself in uncomfortable situations to stretch yourself, like you said. And if it doesn't work out, you can always go home. You always have home to fall back on. So while you're young, that's your time to be uncomfortable. That's your time to struggle. You know, when I moved to New York, I was making $6 an hour. You know, I used to call my mom all the time. My bank account is negative. Mom, can you deposit some money in my account? But now I laugh at that because I'm like, that was part of the journey. That's what kept me going. And so, you know, I always think that it's just so important to do the work right after you graduate while you're young and you can do that while you're flexible before you have kids and you don't have the responsibility. Even if you do have kids, you know, even if you do, I feel like try, you know, if you have a dream that you want to achieve, go for it. Just go for it and figure it out. But I do always think that it is great when you are feeling uncomfortable, then you know you're doing something right.
I love it. So here's another question I have for you. I know that along your journey, you have encountered obstacles, and I'm sure you have encountered hearing no's and roadblocks. Can you share with us, how do you navigate when hearing a no or encountering a roadblock?
Well, it's funny. I will say this to everybody who wants to work in beauty or fashion. It's very competitive, especially being a person of color. I think now there definitely are more faces. And I think that that's one thing that I pride myself on is being, trying to set an example and to be a face for students like you who can see someone who looks like them to know that they can do it. Someone who's done it and you can say, okay, if she did it, then I could do it. I didn't see many faces that look like me, especially dark skin in beauty. Like it was just unheard of. So that was something that inspired me and motivated me to want to really secure a job in this field because I wanted to be able to show students like you that you can do it. We can do it. But I think, you know, when I think back to when I started as an intern, how many incredible, you know, friends of mine that interned with me, and they got discouraged, you know, they just got discouraged and they ended up moving and they just gave up because it's so competitive. And I was told no many times. There were many positions at different magazines that I applied for that I did not get the role. And I just prayed and I just kept on saying, you know what? I know God has a plan for me and this is what I want to do. I'm not going to give up. And I just tried to I always, and this may be something that I learned because I'm Greek, I'm a Delta. And I think that this is something that I learned just when pursuing Delta, you know, at Howard. It was like, you can't be afraid to ask for what you want. You know, if you are interested in this organization, you have to go approach people that might be intimidating to you, but you have to do it. And you have to put yourself in an uncomfortable position. I think the same goes for your career. There were a lot of people that I just looked up to, and I was very intimidated, but I wanted their help and I wanted to learn from them. So I wasn't afraid to ask for help and ask for mentorship and to approach them. If they said no, they said no, but at least I put myself out there. So that's the one thing that I did that I think helped keep me going is I tried to find mentors. I tried to find people that could really keep telling me like, just keep going, or people that could connect me or people that could I could work under just to learn. And so when times got hard and I was told no, I just kept going, or I tried to connect with someone that could maybe give me an extra boost of motivation. And then once I secured my job, by the grace of God, I worked for someone who truly advocated for me and wanted me to succeed, never took credit for my work, kept pushing me to be my best self. And so I think that, you know, you just have to know within yourself, like, this is what I want, and just stick to the course and not to give up. And that, I promise you, all of us that within the industry that I know that kept at it, the chips eventually fell in place. You know, we all struggled. We were all told no, but we just didn't stop. We were determined, and you just keep on going, and everyone ended up, you know, finding their place in the industry.
So, man, you said so much in that one. I'm not even going to try to attempt to pull out the nuggets. You watching, just go do the replay. But I will say, in listening, the big thing that I just heard with you is your relationship with no is one in which no is not a stop sign.
Yes.
So, you know, if you're watching, define what your relationship with no is going to be early on in your career, and adopt a definition similar to Kahlana's. No didn't stop anything with her.
No.
She kept pushing and going.
Yeah, you have to kind of welcome no, because you will be told no. Everything is not going to just be smooth sailing. You know, you are going to hear no several times, but you have to believe in yourself, and you have to keep going, and you have to keep pushing. And I promise you, when you just stick to the course, it will fall into place as long as you're doing the work.
Okay. Well, thank you. Well, listen, you know, I could keep going on and on, but we are going to wind down now. But the final question that I do want to pose with you, because you do have a community that is watching that we want to support you. I know you have a myriad of projects that you're currently working on. In what ways can we support you? Is there anything that you need from this community to support you in around your big what's next?
Well, I have a few things coming up that I unfortunately can't talk about right now, but you will see soon. But I think the biggest thing that you can do to support me is to support each other. Support each other. You know, I tell everyone that, especially anyone who's interned with me, can tell you that I'm always telling, especially girls that look like me, guys that look like me, you know, with brown skin, you know, support each other, because this industry, there are few of us. And so when you get in, the biggest way that you can help yourself is to pull each other up, help each other out. So I would say, if you could do anything for me, is to look out for each other, to help each other. Don't be competitive with each other. You know, really just there's space and room for everyone. So just support each other and go into it knowing that you're stronger together. So if you have a friend that you know, you're both trying to work in fashion or beauty, like, send each other opportunities, look out for each other, because I promise you, we're stronger together.
I love it. Well, Kahlana, thank you so much for just sharing your wisdom. And I want you to know that we are so proud of you. Dream Project, Toyota, Harlem's Fashion Row, we all knew. We got to get Kahlana here to share.
Oh, thank you.
So, and if you're watching, continue to stay in tune and follow Kahlana on all of her IG handles. I'm sure we'll be dropping them into the file so you can see, and we will continue to support you. So
thank you so much. Thank you for having me, and good luck to everyone out there. You got this.
Now, for those that are watching, if you enjoy this Fueling Fireside Chat one-on-one, we want to also encourage you to check out our Fireside Chat with costume designer and stylist Shiona Torini, which you can also access right here within our Toyota Dream Project virtual booth. While you are there, we also want to make sure, please take the Toyota My Style, My Way quiz. You will learn something about your style. You will learn something about Toyota, and you will be entered into a chance to win a digital gift bag. We're giving away digital gift bags throughout this entire session, Toyota is. So make sure to go over there and take the Toyota My Style, My Way quiz. Thank you all for tuning in to this Fueling Fashion Fireside Chat.